Well, we have Donna Dahl here today from the wonderful Village Library, and I'm so glad you're here to fill in.
So nice to meet you.
Yeah, and this is your first time?
No, actually, I was here, but you were on vacation.
Okay.
I was interviewed by Lisa Hart last time.
Well, I'm glad you're here today.
Thank you.
And how long have you been volunteering at the library?
Actually, since about 2014.
So
about 6 years now. And I've lived here about 10.
It's a wonderful place. Mm-hmm. It really is. And of course, Eileen just raves about it. So what we're talking about today, start of the new year and start of book clubs. And there are several different book clubs, right, that people can join.
Yes, there are. And in fact, we have a new brochure that's out.
Yes.
And on the front and the back page, when you first open it, mm-hmm. it tells all the information about the library.
Yeah.
The good details mm-hmm. that people want to know, you know, whether it's how long you can have a book out or how many
right.
books you can have out and fines and all that, and phone numbers and everything. And this year, one of the changes is that I've sort of highlighted the areas that have our information about our online presence.
Yeah,
so
online
we have two of those. Yes. Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Thank you. I'm glad you enjoy it. And then we also have a space, a club space mm-hmm. on the VMS web space. So that's highlighted too because they can go there and find information, the brochure, etc.
Yeah. Now, the book clubs, is there three?
Yes, there are three.
Okay.
There are three, and the two of them are in their beginning their sixth year.
Wow.
So we have a second Monday that's beginning its sixth year, and in its sixth year, we have 24 plus members.
Wow.
That's
very good.
Yeah, the third Tuesday book club is beginning its sixth year also, and we have 22 plus members in that book club. And then our third book club is fairly new. This is only the second year that it's been in existence.
Mm-hmm.
And we started out with 30 the first year, and usually people get really excited about new things,
yeah.
and then things sort of settle down. So we still have 20 plus members in that book club also. And it has a focus. The focus is women's voices.
Okay.
So we always select, or we agreed to always select women,
okay.
female authors.
So this is the Wednesday book club, right?
Right.
Now, the
Wednesday.
Other ones, do they have a focus or just kind of
no,
pick books
it just
like?
Depends. And we go through an annual process. Originally, they started out with every few months, people would suggest books and they would vote on them right then and there, and that was it. And then they do it again in 3 months and again in 3 months. So I suggested that we try a method that I had used in another book club where we do an annual process, then you only do it once a year,
yeah.
for instance, which is very helpful for the person that's
yeah.
trying to do all the work.
It is.
And it also gives the folks that are in the book club an opportunity to look around and find new books. So it gives them more time and they don't have to do it every couple of months. So it's worked out really well. We've been doing it ever since then.
So some of these books, I'm looking at them, some are, you know, reasonable size, but there's others that are quite lengthy.
Right, and as a matter of fact, what we do every year are our books that have the most pages, whichever one that is. For instance, you'll notice at the top there, January 13th, we're reading Overstory.
Right.
And a lot of pages, 600
yes.
plus pages. Anyway, the book with the most pages always goes to January because we actually have 2 months to read it then because we do not have a discussion in December.
Okay.
That's when we announce our new books.
So that way they get these books, even though these are dates that they meet, people know in advance. In other words...
Yes, a whole year in
advance.
In fact,
when I'm looking down here, you already have January 2021.
Right, okay. Right, Weight of Ink, and that's 592 pages,
yes.
another lengthy one. However, 2 months again to
yeah.
read that.
Now, is there a cost to join these book clubs?
No, there's no cost whatsoever, and we encourage everyone that likes to read. You'll find book clubs are different than they used to be. Used to be just kind of a way to meet new people and that kind of thing.
Right.
Nowadays, from my personal experience, they're mostly populated by thinkers.
Oh, interesting.
Yes, they want to come and have an opportunity to read books that are not just all by the same author that they're used to, read books that broaden their perspective of the world around them and the people in it.
Yeah.
And so
that's very good.
Yeah, it is. And the discussions are so interesting when you have the opportunity to see what somebody else is thinking about the same thing you both just read.
Yeah, I think it'd be interesting just to see how you come up with these books.
Yeah.
That is got to be a huge process.
Well, actually, nowadays, I started everybody on a website called bookmovement.com about a year and a half ago. And so now everybody, we've migrated everybody, so they're on there, they know the website. During the year, there's an area where they can go ahead and put up books they might want to nominate. They can take them back down if they don't, but at least it's a depository for them to put ideas.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the year, I have a cutoff time and I say, okay, that's you have until X, and put all any books and get your two or three books that you want to settle on for nominations.
Very good.
And then I print out a list that looks similar to this.
Sort of a preliminary
list? For each book club.
Okay.
Yeah, no, this these are the nominations.
Okay.
This is the ballot. So then everybody gets one of these, and they have an opportunity to vote for 11. We had here 31, so they have to choose 11, and they have to put them in order of the book they most want to read.
Wow.
So it's a weighted, and I do a spreadsheet, and it's a weighted average vote.
So it sounds like these people, they get these lists, do a little research. They have to really know what these books are.
Right. I mean, actually, the website's so helpful because, yes, they want to do research, you're so right, before they even put them up
there. What's the name of that website again?
Bookmovement.com.
Okay.
And when they're up there, one of the great things about it, nobody has to make a big list of that includes some a paragraph or so about the particular book. Instead, what they're able to do is click on the book, and it gives you all the information, all the awards it's won or has it won. Well, not all the awards it has won. In addition to all the other people on Book Movement, how they've been rating it. And so there's a lot of information there, just there.
Yeah,
so they can
that is fantastic.
Choose then from, you know, when they go ahead and vote.
Great way to kind of research books.
It seems
too, for
get
anyone.
Us books that the whole group enjoy more.
Now, are these some of your favorite books, or what made you bring these in?
Okay, well, this is Overstory, the one we were just talking about. And we're reading this right now. And I thought it might be interesting for you to look at this. This was a book that we read a year or so ago, Lab Girl. This is fiction. This is nonfiction. They're both about the environment.
Wow.
So we've read about the first woman that was ever a botanist that got funded in the United States. I'm not sure of that part, but at any rate, she did get funded and got her own lab and everything like that. And she then, this story is a novel about several people that had involvement with trees during their life, significant involvement. And then it goes from there, and eventually they meet up in a some situations that involve the environment.
So, interesting, but this one's a novel,
and
that one's based on, on fact.
Right.
What about the other two? The Roundhouse and Educated.
The Roundhouse we're reading this year. Wasn't published this year. This lady, Louise Erdrich, has written over a dozen novels. She's American Indian. And she has her own little bookstore up in her American Indian territory in the Midwest. And this book is actually a mystery, too. Plus, you learn what a roundhouse is and what its meaning was in the Indian culture.
So this is a novel. I mean, this is fiction, but it's based on her surroundings.
Right,
what she knows.
Right.
Yeah.
Her not only her environment, but also how she grew up. And
then
and
the last one here, Educated?
Yes.
This one here. This one, this
Educated,
is a memoir.
Educated, yes. So this is nonfiction. And this book.
Let me look at that one.
Yes.
So this is it seems like somebody who worked in the world of education, a teacher or?
No,
or
actually,
what? She
wasn't allowed to be educated when she was young, and
then
she became
okay.
educated later on. Her family lived in southern Idaho in a little town, and her father was anti-government. And so he said, my kids are not going to school. They're not going to hospitals.
Wow.
They're not going, we will take care of them, period, here in our own family. And so this is the story
wow.
of what her life was
story?
Like. Yes,
wow.
it is. It is. Nonfiction is a biography. So it is really interesting.
Yeah.
Right. Right.
Yeah, great books.
Okay.
And if people want to find out more about the book club, of course, you can go online to the Village Library web pages. And again, the book clubs meet on the second Monday, the third Tuesday, and the fourth Wednesday of the month. You can join at any time.
Please, yes.
Yeah.
Just give us a call or just come on, you know, pick up the brochure and come on in and join us. Even just listen if you want to and decide whether, which book club or...
Yeah, I think it's fantastic.
Thank you.
Gets people to read, but also it gets people to come together once a month and talk about it and get to know
and
others.
Think. And
yeah,
and
think. Very good. Thank you, Donna.
Yeah.
Great
thank
to see you,
very
again.
Much.
You take
okay.
care, and we'll be right back.